Hi, this is Fran.
Hi, this is Doogie, and we are half of Travis.
And you're watching us on Fresh Milk TV. The most important thing about, for us, that keeps the glue that keeps our band together is the friendship in the middle of the band between the four people. This was present before the band existed, so it was always about the four of us. So we do everything that we do in the band, we do to look after this glue. So if it means taking 2 years off, then you take 2 years off, because when you're on the road for a long time, you begin to you get tired of the sight of each other, and you're like, you just want a break. And we've got families and we've got other things. So I think Travis are in the best shape that we have ever been in at the moment. I don't know why. I think maybe our kids have grown up. My child is 10 years old
Day after tomorrow.
Day after tomorrow. Dougie's boy is 8 years old tomorrow.
Yeah.
And so it feels that maybe the kids are a certain age that we can concentrate on the band again. It's good, man.
That's a good question. I don't know if there is a secret. I think the secret, the real secret is it's luck. I think you work as hard as you can. You try, you write, make the best thing that you can. You make the songs as good as you can possibly make them. And you try and make them honest and trying to communicate with somebody directly. But really, you know, you can do that as much as you like, but success, if you want to call it like commercial success, is pretty much entirely down to luck. If you won't come down
till we hit the ground. I left school, both of us left school, and we went to art school. I went to be a painter, and Dougie...
I went to be a sculptor.
And so, if anything, then I could paint... pardon me, my phone is ringing. My son is calling me. But I don't think you can be a professional painter. It was always the arts with us. And I don't know if you could be a professional sculptor.
I trained as a sculptor, but I could probably be a welder.
It'd be one of those parrots with a big long beak. Don't know what they're called. You know, the black and white ones with
toucan.
The colour... A toucan.
Yeah.
It'd be a toucan. But you still need the moon to shine. Usually Travis records are quite inward looking. They're like, what am I feeling in here? And this album is quite looking outside, and what are we feeling about what's going on out there? Very subtly, there's a couple of songs that have a little dig at modern
contemporary culture, for yeah. want of a better word.
So yeah. Is just a feather fly, and can
come down. You know, bands never really made money out of selling records. You know, unless you were gigantic like Pink Floyd or something. You know, bands, the record companies make money out of records. Bands always really made their money out of touring, out of shows, and that's kind of how it is now. You know, it's just, there's always some mediating factor between bands and audience, and that mediating factor takes the lion's share of, you know, money. But I think now we're in an interesting time. It's a very interesting time for music, and I think that maybe this kind of freedom and democracy of information and of potential allows musicians to get their stuff out there more. There's a kind of freedom of a free-flowing thing of getting music out there without having to go through a filter system, which has a positive and negative effect. It means that lots of stuff gets out there that maybe shouldn't, and you have to kind of plough through that. But it means that great stuff has an opportunity to get to an audience, and then it can be played live, and then people can, you know, make a living maybe out of playing live. But that's, we're kind of back to that point. We were talking about this the other day, and we kind of we had initially the idea of 12 albums. So we're kind of we're at album 8, you know, and so we'll see how it goes. But it's all dependent on songs, you know. We don't think in terms of albums. You just think in terms of one song at a time. When you're writing or recording, you're just concentrating on that song, and then you kind of put them together and go, oh, this runs well as an album, or oh, well, that maybe could have been better or could have been edited. So it's always very much in the moment, thinking about the songs. 'Cause the best, a little bubble, I'm